breath.
Test check 1-2. Test check 1-2. Test check 1-2. Mic test check 1-2. Testing 1-2. Testing 1-2. Test 1-2.
Piano.
Test 1-2, alright. Test 1-2. Test check 1-2.
Experiences indoor kite performances by artisans and artists from around our country and outside of the country that are going to perform indoor kite flying like you may have never seen before to the music of their choice, flying the kite that they've chosen, sometimes that they've made themselves, but they're coming from all over to share their passion, our passion with you. I may even get a chance to do that. So how about it? Who's here to fly? Watch some indoor kite flying. Ready? Excellent. Well, hey, I'd like to first of all thank the city of South Padre Island and the CBB for their support for the SBI Kite Fest. We couldn't have done it without them. Also, a quick special thank you to all of our hotel sponsors. They've generously provided rooms and condos for all of our flyers here tonight. And we're all very, very comfortable, I gotta say. And we hope you took advantage of their Kite Fest rates and are here for the weekend. That's the Isla Grande Beach Resort, Courtyard by Marriott. The Inn at South Padre Island, the Borough, staying there myself, very nice. Holiday Inn Express and Ramada. And lastly, wanted to say thanks to all of our magnificent kite flyers. You guys are awesome. We know that your passion for kite flying not only brings you here, but around the world, and it makes events like this really incredible and impossible to happen. So, let's have a round of applause. For all our flyers that are here to watch. We're going to be fun, we're going to have a good old time, and what I'd like to do now is, if I could, our pastor from the Chaplin on the Sea, Mr. Bowder is here, and he's going to give us the prayer before we have our national anthems. Here you are, sir.
Would you please, bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we are grateful for a time that we can get together. God, we are proud to live in a country where we can celebrate our freedoms and spend time socializing and being with our friends. God, I ask that you would be with us tonight and you would bless the time that we're together. It's in your holy name we pray. Amen. Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much. Okay, so we're going to let a few people sit down here. And something I want to let you know, quick notes. What we wind up doing, because this is indoor flying, it requires no wind. And what happens when we have doors open in a convention center? Oftentimes the wind is sucked in either by their handling units, or today we've got a little bit of wind outside, so that's helping change the pressure inside here. So what we're going to do for every performance is shut that door, so everybody's sort of held captive in here for 2 minutes, so about the size of the length of the music you're going to hear, then we'll open up the doors again and give a usually about a two-minute pause between each of the flyers. So we ask everyone to, if you happen to have yourself outside the door, you'll be able to let back in after we get that performance over with, to give the flyer that stillness of air that they require. Okay, so without any further ado, we're going to go ahead and have international kite flying sensation, Mr. Paul de Bakker, perform, because this has traditionally been an international kite festival. We've often had representatives here from Canada. I believe we do have at least one coming in. I don't know if she wants to stand up and make herself known, but anyhow, welcome to all our Canadian friends, and also our guests from Canada. And without any further ado, when Paul's ready, we will fly to the Canadian National Anthem, immediately followed by our National Anthem.
Thank you.
was really well done. It was a beautiful kite. A kite designed by a gentleman out of the Pennsylvania area. Doug was stout. And that has a really cool eagle look to it. It's actually called the Bird of Prey. Okay, we're gonna let everybody settle into their seats, and we're gonna give our very first performer a chance to get out here on their stage. This guy, Conk, as I like to call him, good friend. He hails from the great state of Virginia, Richmond area. Yeah. And he's flying himself a three-wing kite, custom colors. I like the purple in there, definitely. Mark started flying kites in 1984, and he's actually competed very first East Coast Sport Kite Championship in Wildwood, New Jersey. And he placed, he didn't win that one. So, actually, in addition to being a member of two different kite clubs, the Richmond Air Force, which is an awesome club, and Wings Over Washington, which I know about, because I'm from the DC area, he's also a member of the Broadline team, the Misfits, WOW, which you'll hopefully be able to see tomorrow and Saturday out there on the flats when things dry out and calm down a bit, perhaps. Oh, no. As I understand, things are all green light so far, right, Bill? All right, good stuff. Okay, well, we get the high sign from our buddy Mark. We will let you enjoy some of his music. I'm going to give just a few more people a chance to grab a seat. Everybody point out the empty seats out there for these folks. Wow, we pretty much every seat full. This is cool. Very cool. Got some seats over here too. Anybody need some?
Up here.
You got
one
there on your
seat.
Would you go ahead?
Crowds coming in. Yeah, kids, that's what I love to see. You guys like to see kites flying? What's up? Hi. What's your name?
Hi.
You shy. Didn't say much. Hi. Very cute. I know, Mark, this is your favorite. This is the best part, isn't it? The wait. Why can't I start flying, man, please? Okay, I think your field's clear enough, right? You good to go, buddy? All right, ladies and gentlemen, from Richmond, Virginia, Mr. Marc Conklin. Conklin. Well done, my friend. Well done. Interesting little tidbit. He's actually flying a kite that we typically see him fly outdoors.
What?
How can that be? Well, this one's just designed. We call it a super ultralight, and it even has the sticks he likes to have when he's flying outside. But this guy's got such mad skills, he can fly this outdoor kite indoors. So there you have it. Thanks again, Mark. Okay, coming up next, this gentleman's from Medford, Oregon, Mr. Eli Russell. Yeah, he's a multi-disciplined flyer. He's been a pilot since he began back in 2010. It's not that long, only 11 years. He's a youngster compared to some of us oldsters out here. Yeah. But you should see how much talent this guy has for being that youngster that is. Became a regular at the iQuad clinics back in the Northwest events. He's also a member of the 2019 Mega Team, that world record holding team that held 101 quad line kites in the sky all at once. As an almost exclusive inland flyer, he's pretty well known for his nonstop energy, first in, last out type guy. And he's also developed a distinct style as an urban quad flyer. That means he flies pretty much anywhere. It doesn't matter if there's buildings, trees, parking lots.
Waterfalls.
Oh yeah. I flew vicariously through some of his posts where he's outdoors in forest settings where he's got waterfalls around him and he's flying indoor kites around these waterfalls. It's pretty crazy stuff. But he's quite an amazing guy to watch. And he's a great friend too. So hey, good to go, Eli.
I'm a little tired today. Bear with me.
He's a little tired.
Just give me a smile.
He's going to try though. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen.
Eli Russell.
How are you? Thank you, Eli. That was some good stuff. Lots of energy for being as tired as you are. Man, did you fly in too? That's been a good joke all weekend long. Stopped about earlier today. Hey, so what am I next? We've got a couple of flyers. Husband and wife team, in fact. Phil and Barb Burks from Portland, Oregon. They have been flying quite a bit, long time together, for over 20 years, in fact. And mostly what they fly are large inflatable. These are critters you might see outdoors, big octopi, big whales, and mago, what do they call those? Trilobites, and troglobites, cats, dogs, dragons. In fact, this guy just, I think you just flew in from Lake Okeechobee, Iowa. Okeechobee, Iowa. Okeechobee. Please forgive me. I ain't from these parts. So anyhow, frozen Kitefest there. That was really unbelievable, and Phil and Barbara had a very great time there flying kites, and they have flown pretty much everywhere, including Saudi Arabia in their first ever kite festival. And then in 2018, he was actually invited to show his kites in Dubai. So these guys get around. They're an incredible couple. And they're a lot of fun to fly with. And we hope you guys get a chance to join right here. They're going to be flying at another similar kite to what you saw Bill fly our national anthem to. These are called Birds of Prey. And they're designed by a gentleman by the name of Doug Stout. Many years ago, this guy, Doug Stout, was one of the first guys to use computers to design his sport kites. He had a line of two iron sport kites that he put out, and used a computer to cut out the sail. So this guy's been really very, very into all the specifics behind creating the right lift and drag, and et cetera, to make a very cool glider, which is what we call these type of kites. These actually look strange because it looks like they're flying backwards, but they're not. And, well, let me let Barbara and Phil show you. And by the way, they're going to hand out a little memento coming down the aisle to some of the folks, and hopefully they'll even be able to hand some out while they're flying. What they're handing out is some buttons to represent today's and this week's Kite Festival, the SBI Kite Fest. So without any further ado, Phil, Barb, let me know when you're ready. We'll go ahead and get the music for them rolling for you. Ladies and gentlemen, Barb and Phil Burks.
Hold the door, say please, say thank you.
Amy Doran. Hi, Amy. How's it going? She's from Seattle, Washington. Her along with her son Connor. They're happy to be here once again. I think they were here in 2019 last. Is that right, Amy? I think so. Anyhow, so happy to have you back. Amy's known at festivals around the country for an incredible, amazing rendition of Charlie Chaplin, and often flies routines with her son Connor. So we're going to get to enjoy them flying together a little later. For now, Amy's gonna show us some of the incredible talent that she shares and her passion for kite flying. She's been very integral. She's gonna test out the wind real quick while I talk about it a little bit more. So hey, she actually has been very integral with some interesting social media events that have taken place known as Windless Kites events, Windless Kite Festival, which has taken place out in, where is it, Oregon, I believe, right? Actually, Washington State, right, Long Beach. And so, because of COVID, of course, everything had to go virtual, including this indoor kite festival. So we're gonna be doing it again this year, and the hope is to make it very accessible to everybody.
Everybody.
So it's gonna happen online, I believe in
the 26th of February.
26th of February, after that, everyone's gonna be able to see this. And what this is a group of individuals who have put together their own videotape in whatever environment they like, to fly in a windless situation and submit a videotape, produce it, and create an online virtual festival. So,
and you know
long
what?
Live indoor flying.
A lot of people pick this place because it's their favorite place to fly.
Ah, she says many, many people focused on having their event coming right out of here.
Yep.
All right, Amy, looks like, ladies and gentlemen, she's ready. Without any further ado, Miss Amy Doran.
Give it up for Amy. Very nice job. All right, you all know who I am. I don't know all of you, but I say welcome. Before I bring the next gentleman on, which is on, stay on, I would like a show of the first time you've ever been here to the Indoor Kite Fest. Please stand up. Stand up. Look at this. Can you believe that? You've been here before. Sit down. Thank you. Have a seat. Because everybody always wants to know, how do you fly indoors? I can't wait for the next time you talk to somebody that we watch kites fly indoors. I want to know how you're going to explain it. That is a tough thing. Well, I'm out here to introduce this young gentleman over here named Jim Cosca. Well, you're looking at, but it ain't me. Well, I'm sorry for you. It's your problem. Jim here is from Fort Washington, Maryland. He has flown in multiple places. And one of the most remarkable places, if you've never, and we all looked up there and said, he flies on ice in Wisconsin. Kites on ice. It's hard to believe that they got to do that. He's also been into the desert, Dubai. So he's a traveled man, well seasoned. Jim is also a member of both Team Red Riders and Misfits of WOW. Okay? As well as the founding president of the Kite Club Wings Over Washington, D.C. Don't get a stake with D.C. Okay. He has extreme knowledge of kiting. I'll go off and read the program. That's what I have to do, too. I know. We're getting old.
No, I know.
Do you really? Well, give it up for the best man out here on right now. Jim Cosca.
Thank you.
Captain Jim Cosca. Next up.
Wow, that's a lot of work.
Was it? I don't remember. Paul Master, Germantown, Maryland. So we have another guy from Maryland, okay? So he is the vice president of the Kite Club Wings Over Washington, EC. He gives lessons. It's his passion. So anybody wants a lesson? Not tonight, but we'll do it tomorrow together. Ask him for a little more help. Okay? He's also a member of Red Riders, Misfits of Wow. He's got 25 years on the Kite Festival circuit. That's a long time. Paul enjoys flying in places like the Galapagos Islands, Peru, as well as Trinidad. So without further ado, I give you Paul the Master.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Paul de Bakker. Oh my God. No, Paul the Master, sorry. I looked at this man, I said, Paul de Bakker. This is Paul the Master, ladies and gentlemen. My bad. Same number of syllables.
Hey, right? I traveled down here with him.
That's right. Well, actually, we got separated.
And that's good. That
I was in Houston, he was at Houston Hobby, and then it went on from there. They made it in Arlington, though. Unfortunately, our shot from Houston didn't. But the rental car did. So, thanks, Burks. Okay, coming up next, you guys may have heard of this guy before. He's world famous. And he comes to us from Portland, Oregon. Has anybody heard the name John Barresi before? Everybody applaud if you've heard of John Barresi. Okay, so there's a fair amount in heaven. You guys are in for a treat. This guy knows how to fly kites. Okay, a little secret. He knows how to teach how to fly kites. He knows how to compete flying kites. He knows how to build kites. He knows how to produce kites. The one he's flying, he designed. Plus the second one he's flying, he designed. He's got his own, along with his buddy Bradness, of course. He has come up with a kite company over all the experiences he's brought. an avid kite flyer since 1990, John has earned, 31 national championship awards. Sport kite competition. He's worked hard to promote kiting worldwide as the owner and proprietor of KiteLife.com and now Kite Forge. That's right, Kite Forge is where you can buy all your needs for indoor, outdoor, dual line, broad line. He's got it all together. Over the past decade, he's been highly active in the kite performance scene as founding member of Team iQuad, which was retired back in 2013, leader of three world record mega flies, one of which I was proud, one of the 101 I got to fly in that. And also, he's currently flying the lead position on a little team called Team Kite Life. So, yeah, he seems to have his kites well-trained, his stand-up on the run, and he's getting his second kite together. And like I said, you folks are in for a real treat. John, how are you feeling, man? Been a long time.
Nerves.
All right, nerves and love, that's what it's all about. Well, just have a good time, that's all I care. So I did, I got a chance to fly. You guys didn't know I flew, guys, did you? Yeah. So, yeah, you want to see me flying with the team out there tomorrow. I'll have a good time. I'll be on the way tomorrow in the wind. And it'll be fun. We're going to have a good time. You guys are going to slow the wind down for me a little bit, right? Maybe take it from the 40 that's small right now down to maybe 20. You can all work with that. John, you ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, our good friend, John Barresi. Ladies and gentlemen, John Barresi. Is that amazing or what? And I got dizzy just watching it. Oh, God. It's a lot of sweat. Coming up next, another incredible young man who has been flying kites, well, at least the last 15 years. He's actually been flying since 05. Part of several sport kite teams, such as iQuad and Fly Forum, and the Kite Connection. It's the Kite Collective, not the Connection. I did that. There was something different going on there. I saw it, I read it, and I said, no, that wasn't right. So he's also flying kites in 9 countries across 3 continents, and has several national championship awards and American Kite Flyers Association award from them. So Spence actually hand makes every single kite that you'll see him fly. This one, and there's 2 other red and black ones back there that he flew. And in fact, look at it. In the center of the stage, there's a stack of red, black, and white ones as well. You may even see something happen with that later. So, hey, yeah, without any further ado, let me introduce an incredible kite flyer from SeaTac, Washington State, Mr. Spence Waddy Watson. As I said, it's amazing what kind of flyers we got out here to be able to make your own kite and fly it. I don't know if anybody's ever experienced that, but to be able to make your own sport kite and be able to perform such an incredible performance like that. I feel pretty proud. I think we have at least one really proud fan out here. Right? Is there a fan out here that might cheer special for her?
Yeah.
Actually, she's been probably talking to somebody. Where's your fan? Grandma here?
Come on, baby.
She's just very shy. Oh, okay, she's standing shy there. But if you heard a loud scream in the middle of that last performance, that was her. That was her. I'm looking for her grandson. Okay, hey, I know this next guy. He's from my neck of the woods. Mr. James Fletcher from Baltimore, Maryland. Yes, indeed. Talk about an incredible kite flyer. Here goes one. He's from Baltimore. He's better known as Fletch. He's also a member of the team Red Riders and Misfits Wild, which is a team I'm on along with him. He's the lead guy, and he's got already, in his short stint as being a kite geek, he's got 4 Eastern League Kiting Championship titles. And last 2014, he was the U.S. single line indoor national champion. Single line. He's either flying or single line right now. So, yeah, that's pretty incredible stuff. I told him a few years after he got into it, my thoughts for him were, I said, Fletch, thank you for choosing kites, because as you watch, you get to see this guy's probably good at anything he does. So, you ready, buddy?
Yeah,
that's you. He's got a wagon leg, ladies and gentlemen, Fletch. can't go by the drums, man. I'll tell you what. One more time. Fletch. Listen, he's not very theatrical or a liar. I didn't work on that. It's kind of like me. Well, hey, we got one more flyer, and I think, I don't know if you guys have heard of this guy before. He hails from the great state of Washington with a town that could be for Canada. Anybody guess where that is? Vancouver, Washington? Every time I first heard it, I said, is it Canada or is it Washington? Which place is it? This gentleman, he's been flying kites for a long time. How long have I known you, Scotty? A while back? And I said, this guy's a comer. I said, it's Chris Schultz, who's over here with us. He's joined us from Austin / North Carolina. And here's my buddy Chris. I said, this guy's a comer, man. Back when Chris and I were judging sport fighting back in the 90s. And now he's more of a comer. He's arrived. And he's done everything from flying in many, many countries around the world. Asia, China, Malaysia, Dubai, Far East, Near East, Middle East, everywhere. And he started out that team, the Rev Riders, which a lot of us have been members of in Crowley. And now he's actually flying for our friend, Mr. Bruce Floor of Kite Man Productions. And he is one of the chief flyers, drivers, organizers, man about town for Kite Tales happening right now in Disney World down in Florida. So you guys gotta go down and check him out. So he's been doing it, he does it well. You're going to get to be treated to a great performance right here, right now, from Mr. Scott Weider. Mr. Scott Weider. Unbelievable. This guy is amazing. When I grow up, I'm gonna be like him. And a long way to go. Hey, so got one more quick thing to take care of right before we take a quick break, let you guys rehydrate or whatever you need to take care of. And that'll be just a short break, and during that time we'll let you go out and, like I said, take care of business. But I understand we've got a special quick guest here that decided to come by for a visit, and he has a special prize for one lucky seat holder, ticket holder type person that's in this room right here, right now. So, what he's asked me to do, by the way, his name's Charlie, if anybody has never met him before. Charlie? Say hello, Charlie. Best way you can. Go ahead. There you go. So, what Charlie would like everybody to do is, he looks like he wants to show us something. What he has in his possession. Besides some beautiful flowers. Oh, looks like he wants to give the flowers to the ladies. Adorable. Very nice. No, not anyone. I didn't tell him. Go Charlie. So what he has, besides those lovely roses, is a very interesting little special prize for the lucky seat holder here. You've seen some kites flown, you've seen four line kites, you've seen two line kites, and you've also seen some one string kites. And what Charlie has for the lucky seat holder, smells good, doesn't it, Charlie? Is a one string handbuilt kite from a gentleman by the name of Patrick Tan. And I don't know if anybody's ever heard of it, it's called an iFlight. It's a single line glider kite. I think at least, here's one being demonstrated right here by our buddy John. It's a very, very nice, easy to fly, gentle floating glider. I think I've flown one of those before. You might have seen me flying, not this exact model, but one very similar to it. So what I'm gonna ask, Charlie, you ready to give this thing away? What'd you mount off to? Oh, he's still running around here, thank you. Couple more roses to go. Oh, look, who is that? Sarah Russell Calvin right there. Very nice, Sarah. Sorry. Hey, I know you. You're supposed to be flying indoor here, aren't you, right? Never mind. All right, Charlie, you ready? You ready to do this thing? Got one more rose, all right, here we go. Yeah, that is a really nice kite you got there. Ooh, can I see that kite? Very nice, very nice. Okay, so the way we're gonna do this is this iFlight, very cool. That is the magic iFlight. It's a little smaller than the one we just had out here, but this one is an incredible kite. So what I wanna ask somebody to do is everybody take a look to your right of your seat. If you look down in between the seat you're sitting in and the next seat right beside you, and you look down, and you see a little black mustache staring you right in the eye, who could that be? I want you to stand up and scream really loud, bingo, or whatever you want to yell, because you're the winner. All right, somebody's got it. So you got to see right here, the person's right next to you right there. If you look to your right, staring up at you right here, you don't even have to look under your seat, it's looking right up at you. So somebody's got it. Right here, bingo over here. Bingo over here. Oh, okay. All right, we gotta see it. See, there's a mustache over here, I'm gonna tell you. Is there a mustache anywhere over there? Mustache? Quickly. Oh, it's bubblegum. That's right. Okay. All right, no. Nice shape and all, but a little wrong consistency there. Okay, there is a sticker. Come on, guys, help me out. I know it's going to need to use the bathroom for this one, so I'm going to let them have that opportunity. Charlie, can you give them a hand, maybe a hint of where you might have hidden that mustache? Anyone? I don't see anything. Wait, Charlie is making his way to where the mustache should be. All right, he's going up one row, two rows, three rows, four rows, five rows, six rows. Six rows over, six rows up. I mean, I know we make this happen, come on. Six. Six rows over, six rows in. Yell out, bingo. Okay, we found it. That's right over here. It really did exist. That's right. It wasn't an hallucination. Okay, hey, by the way, I'd like to thank and let you guys know that we've had some incredible entertainment prior to our event and during intermission by Mr. Red Marshall on piano. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. And he's going to entertain us a little bit longer during intermission. So thank you and congratulations to the winner of that awesome kite. You're going to have a good time with that. Hey, Festival shirt's going to be on sale during the intermission. I think I'm wearing one right here or something very similar. And if you like to stay at the island this weekend, please take a minute to stop and register. That way, because the help with the funding of this kite festival is going to be through hotel tax. So if you're staying in the island, we'd really appreciate it if you take a minute to stop and register this weekend and let us know. Okay, so hey, how long are we going to break for?
15 minutes.
About 10, 15 minutes, according to the boss. Okay, so right now, take a break. See you in 15.
Thank you. for me and you. And I think myself, what a wonderful world.
performance field. We're going to get started with the second half of our performances for you guys. Coming up next, out onto our performance stage is Mr. Brett Marshall. He hails from New Boston, Michigan.